Yeah, well, I don't know, man. Listen, I've got to go because I've got to film something. We're outside the Barley Mow, one of the finest drinking establishments in East London. Today's going to be an interesting day, though. It includes two of the loves of my life, which are eating food and drum and bass. So we've got a friend of mine, Wilkinson, coming down, who's the self-proclaimed King of Goujons. I've been a big fan of his music. He's a drum and bass producer who's recently released an album called Lasers Not Included.
It's just the old, like, it's just one thing, yeah, you can have it with anything.
So he's kind of taken over the commercial drum and bass scene at the moment.
Just since things have kicked off for you, or have you always...
I need something to spend my money on, so I'm like...
What do you know about Goujons?
Very little. I know that you can get, I don't know, they come in a packet in Waitrose. That's about all I know about Goujons. Dips are important with Goujons.
You can have it on its own, you can have it with every dip, you know what I mean, even brown sauce.
Ranging through the colours of the rainbow, from the reds of ketchup to the whites of mayonnaise is always essential.
Is white in the rainbow?
I don't know, I did think of that, but no, probably not. But it's going to be a head-to-head challenge. Me, Wilco, and a 2-foot-long fish goujon sandwich. That's it, basically. We're taking it back to the rawest elements right now.
Does he like fish?
I fucking hope so.
I was brought up on fish fingers, so like that fish, finger fish fingers and chips, mate. And
you know, I've always got time for sort of scummy food. Although, no, I've got love for goujons, but, you know, it's a 20-minute oven situation. It's not like a culinary master.
Technically, a fish finger is a goujon.
Basically, yeah. Technically.
Because that's why today we're obviously dealing with fish goujons, which I thought might have been a bit controversial. But
fish goujons will go down easier.
This is a catfish. Louisiana catfish.
That sounds like a cheap, bad, poor fish, is it?
This is kind of the heart and soul of Southern America.
I can speak on behalf of Red Dog. It's a quality goujon.
Yeah.
It's a quality, and they're small. They're kind of like broken down pieces. Like you might get. Mm. It's a powerful goujon.
For me personally, a goujon is a strip. It's a strip. That's the shape of a goujon, and then it's breaded. There you go.
What sauce have we got?
Sauce. We're gonna have to consult the chef, yeah. But I imagine it's a kind of a kind of high-end mayonnaise-y vibe sort
good,
of
yeah.
Dressing.
We use two sauces in the sandwich. Well, one's our Red Dog sauce, and the other one is a remoulade. It's a kind of American version of a tartar sauce. So it's a mayonnaise base, it's got some ketchup, pickles, capers, red onion, parsley.
What's the fat content in that?
I don't know, he's counting.
It's not the goujon that's going to be the issue, it's the bread.
It's also the sauce, the lubrication.
So sauce is your friend, bread is your...
Enemy?
Yeah, enemy, definitely, yeah.
And is it soft? How are we doing on the... Have you had a little poke?
This is what you get here that you don't get anywhere else.
So what are you doing now?
Steaming.
What's that do?
I don't know, it just wakes everything the fuck up.
They're also steaming the bun, so it's going to be soft. So
okay, right.
Hopefully there will be no... blood-induced goujon breakdown.
Even though the dancing's done, don't worry because the night is young. Who cares where we go? We're ready for the afterglow.
Goujon guns.
Did I just hear someone's jaw crack?
Wow. Perfect. Ridiculously, just the right amount of sauce, bread to fish ratio is ridiculous.
I've got it all around my face.
Yeah, let me go.
It's fucking good, man. Really good.
Yeah, man.
Are you alright?
Mm-hmm. You just need to let go, man. And just become one with the goujons. I think I've got lettuce in my cask.
So fish and mayonnaise-based sauce down your cask.
Mm-hmm. Comes off in a week, so that'd be fine.
I have to say, the bread, it's not making me bleed, mate.
Mmm. Moisture levels are high right now. That is one hell of a goujon. Right. I've not seen them in Waitrose.
This wouldn't be first date food, would it? I mean,
For the right lady?
Yeah.
First date food, baby. I don't know whether to take the approach of... Whoop. Hi.
Loves a fish goujon, that one.
If she could love me eat this, she could love me through anything.
Yeah.
You are pretty bestial at the moment.
Henry VIII set the levels for people who are into this sort of shit.
Mm. I mean,
he had girls by the fucking truck loads.
I don't know if they could steam bread like this back then.
And if they could, off me the head. Smoke games are slow. We're speaking our own language. What we're talking about now.
Hmm. I understand what I'm saying. Whether or not you understand it. Look at that.
I can't zip it.
Is it a bit like being in a nightclub where you kind of, a normal person wouldn't be able to understand what someone at a drum and bass wave was saying, but you have a sort of empathy that...
When people come up to you and their eyeballs are sort of the size of a 1p piece. I mean, he's like, even to the point where he's getting bits and trying to fill his own little mini sandwich.
He's deconstructed it.
Oh, smashed it.
And I can honestly set hand on heart, say that at no point through that was the goujon itself not an absolute pleasure to eat.
It's worth the catfish hole you're in now.
I'm in a
CF hole. I'm holing out right now.
I mean, I want to look at a catfish.
I need to maybe breathe some air. Maybe lie down for a bit.
God, feeling like John Candy right now.
When you wrote Afterglow, was this what you were imagining?
Yeah, I mean, we're experiencing the Afterglow, definitely. I don't know what's going to happen.
There's a lot of exhaling going on right now.
Yeah, it is.
Like, exhaling feels good.
I'm definitely getting a taxi back. I'm not getting on a tube. Because I'm just going to be... Everyone's going to be like...